I'm Julia, and welcome to day two of my crawl adventure in South Korea with my crawl body, my mom.
Wow, it's just so good.
On our first day in Seoul, we went to the oldest street market, tasted the most popular Korean soup and barbecue dishes, and went up the highest skyscraper in the country. The whole city from above. This is insane. Now, we're off to Gangwon Province, on the east coast of South Korea, to find out where Koreans source their freshest ingredients. We are still with our guide, Jin, and she just told us that the freshest ingredients in South Korea come from the province Gangwon.
Yes, that's why I'm taking you to the Gangnam City, which is located at the eastern coast of South Korea, also surrounded by the ocean and a mountain. Isn't it beautiful in here?
It's beautiful here. But before anything else, can we start our day with coffee?
Then you are just the right place. The Gangneung is a very well-known place for city of coffee.
Yay! Let's go!
One of the most popular destinations in Gangneung is Anmok Coffee Street, a whole street dedicated to coffee.
There are so many coffee shops. Since when have the Koreans been into coffee?
Well, actually, when the coffee first landed in this country, it was more or less American influence. But for the moment, because most of Korean people are, you know, very workaholic, so they need a lot of caffeine.
To stay awake.
Exactly.
And energized.
How do you find out or like pick which one to go to?
Well, actually, along the many ones, actually, there's one place, a very famous one, the special barista. They bring the many different type of coffee.
Okay.
So would you like to try that one?
Yeah, let's go.
All right, we are at the Bohemian Roaster, one of the most famous cafe in Gangneung. This shop is run by one of our first generation of the barista master.
Wow.
Mr. Bak, who is roasting the coffee until now and still brewing the coffee. Wow. So, how excited?
Yeah. Very exciting.
How many years ago did this first generation barista start all of this?
He actually started about 30 years ago in Seoul.
In Seoul, yeah, okay.
And he was quite successful.
Okay.
Then he actually moved into this Gangneung city. That's why after he moved into this city, the Gangneung became the origin of the coffee city.
Oh, okay.
It became the coffee city.
Exactly.
It became known for the coffee. But so this is the first. This is like Bohemian Roasters is the first.
Yes.
Okay, I think this is ours. Great. Wow, look at the cups. So pretty. What is this that you ordered for me?
Well, I ordered cafe oil, which is like French style coffee.
Oh, it's very sophisticated. No, I don't really drink strong coffee, so I just really have to learn.
I think you should go first.
Let's go. To the first of many more coffee for me.
Okay, let's see your reaction.
Oh, it's nice.
You like it?
I like it.
Wait, what is this one called again?
That's Espresso Mild.
So this is Espresso Mild. This is what I just had. Well, it's pure black coffee. I like my black coffee this way because then you know there is less calories. I like it because it keeps me full and awake. Now that we had our morning coffee, we're energized and ready to start crawling. This coastal province has kept to their traditional values, making Gangwon the perfect place for a traditional food culture experience center. I learned that the Koreans value their food so much that they have a center dedicated to their traditional Korean food.
This is Jeonggangwon.
Yeah, so basically, if you're a tourist and you really want to know more about traditional Korean food, this is the place to go. So let's check it out.
Let's check it out. They have an exhibition hall, cooking rooms, and a fermentation area showcasing Korea's rich and well-preserved food and wine culture.
So they also have cooking classes here, and I'm so excited that Julia will be learning how to cook today because she's building her own house and she's going to be living independently. So that means you have to learn how to cook for yourself.
Yes, and this is going to be very, very fun because we are going to be cooking Korean dishes here in Korea. Now that's what you call authentic. So stay tuned because later on we will be cooking bibimbap. When we get back on the crawl. Hey crawlers! We're exploring Gangwon in South Korea. We saw the beautiful coast and well-conserved environment of the province. And we're still at Jeonggangwon, where they also preserve traditional Korean food culture. We want to learn how to make authentic injeolmi and authentic bibimbap, so Mom and I are going to take a cooking class here in Jeonggangwon.
Yes, so I'm so excited to learn, so let's go.
Let's go.
Let's go, let's go, let's go.
Let's go, let's go, let's go. Okay, so right now we are going to learn how to make injeolmi.
So this is rice cake and it's supposed to be sweet?
Not so sweet.
Is this considered a dessert?
I have to say, considered a dessert.
It is a dessert.
It also can be a meal because it's made by rice.
So I'm excited to see how it's done.
Okay, let's get started.
First, you have to apply the sesame oil. Wow.
Okay, sesame.
Yeah, because the rice won't stick to the plate.
Okay.
Okay.
Watch this.
There is a sticky rice.
Okay.
And you have to soak into the water about 2 hours of process.
2 hours soaked in water. Okay.
And then you have to steam the rice.
Steam the rice.
After steam it, you actually throw it into here.
Okay.
Oh my gosh, it smells good. And then you start into smashing with this.
Oh, I like that. Okay.
From the beginning, you wouldn't smashing too strong.
So in other words, we're not pounding it like we're angry. Yeah,
exactly. One, two, 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 Wow. You see?
I work out, baby.
Okay, my arms are gonna hurt after. Longer up.
Okay, it's done. So right now we're putting our gloves on. We're gonna transfer everything. We're gonna transfer this rice all over there. What we did first is spread the yellow bean
powder
all over this tray. And then after that is we transferred the rice over here. And then we started to top it with the yellow bean powder again. And then right now she's cutting it into smaller pieces, and then she is continuously mixing it with the yellow bean powder.
Oh wow, it's very sticky. It's like our espasol. Stickier. I'm not even swallowing it yet, and it's already so filling. You know, it's gonna be so filling.
It's really good as it is, but I think it would be even better if it were sweeter. Yeah. Or maybe it's because I'm a sweet tooth. We just learned how to make injeolmi, and luckily, after this, we're still gonna be with them because they're gonna teach us how to make
bibimbap,
the famous bibimbap.
Yay! Wow, I love the bowl.
It's good for everybody.
Okay, wow,
nice.
Jen, can you tell us more about the ingredients?
This is bean sprout.
Bean sprout, yeah.
Toge.
Carrots. Radish.
Zucchini.
That's it.
Okay. And spinach.
Okay, spinach.
And those three of them are from the wild vegetables from the mountain.
From the mountain. Wow. Very fresh. Very fresh. Organic. So that's how special it is. Mm. Okay, so it's decoration now.
Yes, perfect.
Okay, Jewel.
You have to decorate the colors matching together. So there's a different colors.
Okay.
The bibimbap is very, very colorful as we speak. The pattern, they just want it to look like a flower.
Flower.
Actually.
Wow. There, so nice.
It's all like going straight.
Mix all together?
I don't want to destroy this thing.
Wow, so
you can smell the fresh vegetables, the mixture. You can smell it as they are.
Yes.
See?
It smells so
healthy. I need more chili paste healthy. In my life.
So healthy.
So tasty.
She made it. It's really big.
Mmm. It's really good. You can actually taste the freshness of the vegetables. And you know that the chili paste is authentic. It tastes so different.
It's so rich in taste. The chili paste is perfect.
The vegetables.
The vegetables are crunchy and very fresh. I can taste it.
Well, now I know that how it's done. The experience, of course, is nice when you learn a new dish from a different culture. And this is how it's served, by the way, okay?
And this is the authentic bibimbap, so you just learned how to make authentic bibimbap. You appreciate the food more because you're the one who put the hard work into it. You know how you made it, and the more it's like you're connected to the food you're eating because you're the one who made it. So it's really different.
Yes, and of course when you realize where the ingredients were sourced or how it was prepared, then you know na mas masarap kumain when you know that the food is fresh, the ingredients are fresh.
Speaking of the fresh ingredients, well, the most fresh seafood comes from Gangwon Province. So let's go to the Juminjin Fisherman Market.
Juminjin Fisherman Market. Let's go! Right, fresh
let's go.
Seafood!
Let's go!
Let's go! We are here at the Juminjin Fisherman Market. This is where the local fishermen bring their fresh catch and the people will choose what they want to eat and they cook it in the restaurants nearby. So, because Julia is really allergic to even the smell of shellfish, so we're just going to choose the fish for her and then we're going to bring it there and we're going to eat the grilled fish together with her. Happy!
Oh, la, la.
Grilled fish. Wow.
Good.
With steaming hot rice. Perfect. She's happy.
Eat it.
This is the one that we picked at the market, the fisherman's market, right? So this came from the wild.
Hi. How do you like it?
It's really good. Okay, if I'm not mistaken, this is the one that I picked at the fisherman's market a while ago. And this is supposed to be a delicacy here. Mmm. Good. Oh, it reminds me of uni. Mm-hmm. Japanese uni. Mm-hmm. This had more impact.
Mm-hmm. I tried the fish. It's like our fish back home.
Yeah. Yeah.
Because it's hard, right?
Yeah,
it's fine. The
but it tastes really fresh.
This dinner is such a good way to end our trip here in Gangwon Province.
Let's eat more.
After having coffee at Anmok Coffee Street, learning how to cook bibimbap at the Jeonggangwon Food Museum, and finally eating fresh seafood in Juminjin, we can say that our quick but packed trip to Gangwon Province is complete. It's time to head back to Seoul and find out what other culinary treats the capital city has to offer. Our journey continues only here on The Crawl. Before the break, my mom and I were at Gangwon Province where we had an amazing experience drinking newly roasted coffee, eating fresh seafood, and cooking authentic bibimbap. Now, we're back in Seoul to do some more crawling. Our trip to Korea is about to end and I feel like 2 days is super bitten. para malibot yung buong Seoul.
But Jin, since it's our last day, how can we make the most out of it? How can we maximize?
That's why we're at the K-Style Hub. This is the one-stop center for the tourists. You can see everything about the Korea.
K-Style Hub. Okay, I'm so excited. We're gonna see Korea in one place.
Yes.
Okay. All right, then let's go.
Time to explore. All the information tourists like us need is here in K-Style Hub. It's not just an information center, but it's also a fun place to try unique Korean adventures. Like going to the Hallyu Zone and taking pictures with famous K-pop stars.
We can also sample hansik, or traditional Korean dining, check out their high-tech medical tourism facilities, and even go to far-off tourist spots around the country via virtual reality. So right now, I'm in the market.
This is so cool.
Wow, I didn't see this place yet here in Korea. Oh no, I can see the ocean.
It shows the entire place. When you look around, even going to the back,
you get to see the places that we missed to see in this trip.
It's a nice experience. Super cool. Mom, you know how much I love bulgogi.
Yes, I know. That's why today's your day, because we are going to learn how to cook bulgogi inside the K-Style Hub.
Let's go, let's cook!
Soy sauce, 2 tablespoons.
This is it.
Oh, it smells so good. Amazing. I want to try the pizza.
Perfect. Everything's just perfectly blended together.
Yeah, the meat is soft, it's easy to chew on. She put the right amount of everything, actually. Okay, Mom, I want to try cooking this on our own. Should we try it?
Of course, let's try it.
Let's go.
Transfer here.
Okay, let's start cooking.
Okay, you do it. Okay, I'll watch you. The sauce has already been mixed, Jewel. Okay. This is 2 tablespoons of soy sauce. We have sesame seed on it, and then 1 teaspoon only of sesame oil, and 1 tablespoon of sugar. Okay, you put that first in the bowl, mixing bowl. And then, of course, we have already sliced our leeks, our 2 kinds of mushroom. Okay, put them all together, Jewel, except this. Go.
So, all of this here, and then also the beef.
Yep, there. No, mix it first.
Mix this first.
Yeah. There. Okay, now I'm gonna put the beef.
Okay.
All of this while the water is boiling for the mung beans. And this is the toge sa atin. When it's boiling, we're gonna put it there and boil it for a minute. Yay, I'm so excited. Things that we learned here in Korea are all authentic. And I'm sure that when we serve it at home, our guests will be a little bit culture shock because we do it differently there, but they have to learn, they have to be cultured. Okay, because it's rock salt, but she wants to ground it a little
bit. Not all right.
Yeah.
Watch and learn. Okay, this is what I saw her do earlier.
Okay.
Just have to flatten it out.
Okay, after 1 minute, take off na the toge para hindi siya mawala ng crunchiness. You have to squeeze it talaga so the water comes out. Para hindi siya masyadong saggy.
And then, do we put the salt now?
Salt, okay.
All?
Just a little bit. Okay, and then we're going to put sesame oil. 1 teaspoon? Okay. I'm plating it. Oh, di ba?
Okay.
Oh, talaga.
Pwede ka na sa master chef.
Okay! We're in cooking bulgogi, it has to be in high heat. Okay?
Di ba, no?
It has to be too hot! Okay, Jewel, this is it! Woohoo! Wow! There you go. Grabe, mabilis lang to. This is so fast. This is so quick for your kids. Kanina I saw she was cooking with chopsticks. So, parang masarap nga pag chopsticks. Okay, I think we have to flip it every so often. Ang bilis maluto ng meat. But we also want to maintain the crunchiness of the veggies. I think this is okay already. Is this okay?
Yes, Mom!
Woo, la
la. More slices, come on. Okay, let's taste my mom's dish, which is her beef.
Bukogi!
Okay, let's try it.
Chul na init, ha?
Mas masarap sa kanya. Bakit kaya?
Patikin, patikin.
Mas masarap siya.
Talaga?
Yes, true.
Secret, ah.
This is my mother, everyone. This is my mother. So? Congratulations, Mom.
Okay.
Let's eat. Come on. We are having so much fun here in Korea, but our crawl is about to end. Aww, but before we head back home, we still have one last stop. So stay with us here on The Crawl. Here in The Crawl, we save the best for last. Our last stop is Myeongdong.
If you come to Korea, you must visit Myeongdong. Why? Because this is one of the largest shopping area in Seoul, and they have almost everything from the clothes and cosmetics and shoes and bags. It is paradise for a girl.
I think it's the most perfect way to end this trip, because not only do we have a lot of street food to try, but also there's plenty to choose from all of the things we can buy for pasalubongs. So I think the night is long. I think we have to start.
Let's go. Yeah,
let's start. Go. Can I have one too?
Yeah, here.
Yeah.
It's for you.
Wow, it's so hot. Okay, what is this? Tell us more about.
This is a crepe, which is, they apply the Nutella and some banana.
This is fantastic. First of all, I love chocolate spread. I love crepes. I love bananas. So it's all here, so I'm so happy. Very sweet because of the chocolate spread. So can you tell us more about this street? Because there are so much people right now. It's so busy. What's with the street?
Since Myeongdong is one of the most popular shopping streets, so while people are shopping, at the same time, they like to try some many different types of street food. So actually, at the beginning, it was not this much, but right now, all the way along the main street, you can see the endless street food.
So Jen, can you tell us what the difference is between the Myeongdong market and the Gwangjang market?
Well, I have to say the Gwangjang market food is more related to our traditional food. But in here, the most of the food lineup are the more fusion style.
More?
Fusion?
Fusion.
The mixture of the Korean and Western combination.
Okay.
It is actually completely not a Korean food at all, but it is actually mostly almost Western food for us.
It's so fun here, too much food. Let's walk some more so we can see what the other specialties are. Let's go. Hey, steak. Let's try steak.
Would you like to try some steak?
Yes, please.
Here we go. You can try.
It's really so fun here when it comes to food. There's a lobster, grilled lobster with cheese, and then there's fish skin, and then now there's steak. So I mean, it's really a variety of different kinds of food in the street market. So many choices. Let me see. So this is not expensive.
Yes, it is only like 7,000.
7,000 won. Seems like there's so much people waiting in line for this. Must be good. Mmm, it's good. Soft. good. It's sweet and peppery. There's a lot of pepper.
I'm gonna say.
Good.
And it's not hard. It's not hard to bite onto.
I mean, for 7,000, it's not expensive, but the meat is good. Good quality. Good, good, good. Too much eating on the street.
Steak on the street. Only in South Korea. Okay, I'm starting to get really, really full. Maybe we should start shopping?
Yes, why not?
Do some walking. Yeah, let's go. Thanks for the steak.
Such an amazing time. Thank you so much. What's thank you in Korean?
감사합니다. 감사합니다.
감사합니다.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
And of course, I want to say thank you to my mom for accompanying me on this trip. And of course, I always enjoy traveling with my mom because she's always been my travel buddy, especially when I have work abroad.
Yeah.
And as a simple thank you gift, I have...
Wow, I didn't buy anything for you.
I'm so arte. I have a necklace.
Oh!
It's not the most expensive.
It's okay, it's the thought.
It's a necklace with two hearts. One, the two hearts for her heart, my heart. Mine's the bigger one.
She has a bigger heart.
Just kidding, okay, here.
Thank you so much,
Jewel. I'm so right.
Thank you so much for taking me here to Korea. Oh. Thank you so much! Thanks, guys!
South Korea is such a lovely blend of tradition and progress. As they go forward and evolve, they always have one foot set in their history.
And we also saw the importance of food to their culture and identity. They are not afraid to share their authentic cuisine with the world. And even if their country is constantly developing, they also make sure to stay true to their traditions, through their designs, practices, and most especially in their dishes.
Food crawling is really one of the best ways to get to know a place. Just like Seoul and Gangwon Province, their well-preserved traditions, environment, and values that are reflected in their cuisine make Seoul a truly world-class destination. Thank you, everybody, for joining me and my mom on this fun and thrilling trip to South Korea.
Yes, I really, really enjoyed this trip. Thanks again, Jewel, for taking me with you and so much memories.
We hope we made you crave for more exciting, fun food adventures around the world. Here on
The Crawl.